Hello everyone, welcome back to Auto Trend TV. This is Viprajesh from Ramani Volkswagen Coimbatore Car Showroom. Today I am here with the brand new Volkswagen Tiguan's entry-level comfort line variant. Before we get into the review, here's a quick word on our sponsors. This video is sponsored by Bootmo.com, the spare parts expert. Any brand, any model, any spare part, they offer only genuine quality components along with the cheapest and more expensive options all at one place for you. You can check out their website at Bootmo.com or download the Bootmo app, which is available for Android devices and iOS as well. You can search for the required spare part in the proper category from the scrolling menu on the home screen, and you can also check out the available offers displayed on the home screen as well.
Bootmo also offers return and refund assurance within 10 days of purchase. If you don't like the spare part, you can return it within 10 days without any hassle. Bootmo, the spare parts expert and quite literally the one-stop shop for all your automotive spare part needs.
You may have already seen my detailed reviews of almost all variants of the Volkswagen Tiguan, except for this base level comfort line variant. Just as expected, this base level comfort line definitely looks more stripped down compared to the high line or the top line. To begin with, from the front, you can see that this car has only one singular chrome bar running across the width on top of the grille. That said, while this car also gets the chrome beam and the design elements similar to the higher variants along with the silver finish skid plates, it does not get front fog lamps. The headlamps though are exactly identical to the ones seen on the Highline with a dual barrel-like design and small LED DRLs. That said, the overall design is unmistakably premium and can be identified easily as a Volkswagen Tiguan. The side profile is where the major differences are. While just like the Highline variant, this car does not get chrome accents on the door handles or ORVMs, this entry-level comfort line TSI variant alone gets these 16-inch steel wheels with full wheel covers. That said, the wheel cover design is also pretty tasteful, however, a dual tone design would have been more premium. Just like the Highline variant, this comfort line also gets body colored door handles and ORVMs, along with LED turn indicators. That said, unlike the silver finished roof rails on the higher variants, this comfort line gets black colored aluminium roof rails. Moving towards the rear, all Volkswagen Tiguan's variants look almost the same, and this base level comfort line is no different. Being a premium SUV, even this base level variant also gets the Infiniti LED tail lamps stretching across the width of the car, which is a unique design touch exclusive only for the Tiguan. However, you can see that this base level variant does not provide a rear windshield wiper washer or defogger. That said, just like the top spec variants, this variant also gets the chrome beam on the rear bumper along with a silver finish skid plate. As I have already said, the comfort line, high line and the top line variants of the Tiguan are available only with the 1-liter 3-cylinder TSI turbocharged petrol engine. So that was all about the exteriors of the comfort line Volkswagen Tiguan. Let's now get inside the car to check out the features. Yes folks, I'm right now inside the brand new Volkswagen Tiguan entry level comfort line variant, and this is how the dashboard looks like. Immediately when you compare with the top line or even the high line variant of the Volkswagen Tiguan, this dashboard is much more toned down in terms of materials, colors and the overall feel, and including the seats as well. First let's talk about the seats. These seats, despite being fabric seats, yes, the overall material is more hard wearing and it is definitely not as smooth as the top spec variant's artificial leather seats. However, the seat design remains exactly the same as the top spec variant, so they are really comfortable with more than enough side bolstering and great under thigh support as well. Now coming to the dashboard again, yes, this flat bottom steering wheel remains exactly the same as the Highline variant as well. However, this variant does not get leather wrapping. That said, this variant still gets steering mounted audio controls on both sides, which also includes controls for the instrument cluster as well. And this is the standard 7-inch touchscreen system, which is available as standard on the base level variant of the Skoda Kushaq as well. First, let me just try turning on this car to actually show you the display.
Before that, this here is the key of this base level comfort line variant. It is exactly the same flip key we have seen on the Highline variant as well. Both keys are identical. Now slotting it inside. So this is how everything looks like. And it immediately says that welcome to Volkswagen. This system also gets Android Auto and Apple CarPlay as standard, which is pretty good. The usability is exactly identical to that we have seen on the Skoda Kushaq Active base level variant as well. That said, this display does not get a reverse parking camera, which is completely understandable. However, you get three reverse parking sensors as standard with beep warnings as well. This is the instrument cluster. So this is also again a rather basic looking instrument cluster with only the essential features you need. There is no additional flamboyance or say fancy features integrated into this instrument cluster. It is actually a very simple display. This display, this MID, can be controlled using the buttons on the right side of the steering wheel, including driving data, driving status and all those things. You can go in through the range. So you can basically monitor through whatever information you need. I mean, whatever is your priority, you can choose that to be on top. So that is pretty nice and easy to use. You get also these buttons over here to reset the trip and all those things. So it is rather easy to use as well. This steering wheel is, of course, the standard unit seen on the top spec variants as well, except for the lack of cruise control and all. However, tilt and telescopic adjustment is available as standard on this comfort line variant as well. Coming towards the right side of the steering wheel, you get to see the headlamp controls. This car obviously does not get front fog lamps. The top spec variant also does not get rear fog lamps. So obviously there is no front fog lamp control. Only the headlamps can be controlled using this rotary knob. And the headlamp leveling rotary controller is over here just beside that. Now coming to the center console again, you can see that this car does not get automatic climate control AC. Instead, you can see that these are exactly the manual controls, which look rather good, surprisingly. That's because these controls are exactly identical to that we have seen on the base level variant of the Skoda Kushaq again. Yes, and just like the base level variant of the Skoda Kushaq, the ESP traction control button, turning off button, is actually provided as a physical button just lower to the AC vents on this array of buttons. So that is pretty nice and convenient to have, although I would not recommend you to turn this feature off. Lower down to the AC controls, you get to see this large storage pocket, which is rather nice and padded and rubberized as well, so that whatever you place over there does not get scratched. And this here is the standard 6-speed manual gearbox, available as the only option on this base level comfort line variant with the 1-liter TSI engine. That is this 12-volt charging socket over here. However, this base level comfort line variant does not get the C-type USB ports we have seen on the Highline variant and the top line variant of the Volkswagen Taigan. The only USB port is provided just below the touchscreen system, which is exactly over here, and there is no aux port at all. Now coming just behind the gear lever, you get to see the same array of cubby holes and storage pockets, which is pretty nice and handy to use. Surprisingly, this base level variant, this comfort line variant, also gets slide adjustable center armrest, which also can be opened to reveal a decent level of storage space on the inside. So that is pretty nice and handy again. However, while the glove box size remains exactly the same, there is no cooling function available for this glove box. The cooling function is available only on the Highline and the top line variants, along with the GT variants. That said, all variants, all doors get rather large bottle holders and storage pockets as standard. That said, the feature which surprised me the most is the availability of the soft fabric padding on all door armrests, even on this base level comfort line variant. Despite the lack of chrome finished door handles and not even the faux aluminium finish on the dashboard. That said, talking about the dashboard, the texture is significantly different to what we have seen on the Highline and the top line variants. That's because this comfort line gets a sort of different hexagon kind of pattern, which is actually embossed into the dashboard, and you can actually feel the texture pretty strong and sharp. It looks really good while also feeling very dynamic. So that was all about the dashboard features. Coming towards the roof, this car obviously gets a day-night switch for the IRVM, and all LED cabin lamps are available as standard. You can also control the rear cabin lamps from the front seats as well using this console over here. The sun visors are also exactly the same as the higher variants, with only the passenger side getting a vanity mirror. So yeah, coming towards the driver door, you get to see all four power windows along with electronically adjustable ORVMs. However, the ORVMs are not electronically foldable, on this specific base level model. That said, you can also notice the small blinker located on the inside of the IRVM to notify the driver whether if the indicators are actually turned on or not. So that is pretty nice and handy. Let me just show you how does that work. I'm not turning on the indicators. You can see that the blinker, the small blinker, is actually blinking to notify the driver to turn the indicators off if they are not needed. This car also gets height adjustment for the driver seat as standard, which is also a pretty good feature to have depending on the driver's height. So that was all about the features available on the front part inside the cabin of the Volkswagen Taigun Comfort Line. Let's now take a look at the rear seats. Yes folks, this is how the dashboard of the base level Comfort Line variant of the Volkswagen Taigun looks like from the rear seat. Immediately you can notice a lot of differences in terms of texture, materials and quality, and also appeal when you compare with the Highline or the Topline variants of the Volkswagen Taigun. However, this Comfort Line variant itself offers a lot of essential features, especially on a mid-sized premium SUV such as this. Now, in terms of space for the rear seats, there is no difference whatsoever. The space remains absolutely fantastic. You can actually sit cross-legged over here with the driver. A seat set to my height, which is 5'11 for reference. I have so much space left. Now, coming to the overall seating comfort of this base level Comfort Line variant, yes, the overall seating design is exactly the same as we have seen on the higher variants. That's because you get the greatly comfortable outer side seats with great side bolstering and the really good backrest as well, and more than adequate under thigh support as well. That said, this base level variant does not get center armrest, which is completely acceptable. Even the entry-level Skoda Kushaq variant also does not get a center armrest for the rear seats. However, the bonus of these rear seats are these three adjustable headrests, which are a part of standard equipment even on this base level Comfort Line variant of the Volkswagen Taigun and on the entry-level variant of the Skoda Kushaq as well. Along with that, you also get three proper three-point seat belts for all three passengers for the rear seats, even on this entry-level variant, both on the Skoda Kushaq and the Volkswagen Taigun as well. Talking about other safety features, you get ISOFIX child seat mounts as standard on all variants, with this entry-level Comfort Line variant also getting dual airbags, ABS with EBD, electronic stability program with traction control and reverse parking sensors, apart from engine immobilizer and remote central locking. Now, just like the Skoda Kushaq's base level variant, the surprising feature on this entry-level Comfort Line variant of the Volkswagen Taigun also the availability of rear AC vents. Yes, these rear AC vents are available as standard from this base level variant itself. However, you can see that the rear seat passengers do not get the USB charging ports and not even a 12 volt charging port for their smartphones, which is completely okay because this is a base level variant. However, the overall comfort, the safety, the feel good factor and the space is pretty good in this entry level Volkswagen Taigun as well. So now let's take a look at the boot space.
The Volkswagen Taigun is almost similar in dimensions to the Skoda Kushaq. And so, when you open the boot, the Volkswagen Taigun also offers 385 liters of luggage space, which is identical to the Skoda Kushaq as well. While the size may not be up to Hyundai Creta standards, the overall shape and size is pretty usable. That said, this base model does not get a parcel tray. However, it still offers a boot lamp on the right side along with a 3 kg bag hook on either side for your shopping bags. While the top spec variants, which get 17-inch alloy wheels, get 16-inch spare wheel, the Comfort Line and Highline variants of the Taigun get 16-inch wheels, with the spare wheel being a 15-inch one. So this spare wheel can be used only for temporary purposes. While the higher spec variants offer 60-40 split folding rear seats, this base level Comfort Line variant offers only 100% flat folding rear seats. That said, on all variants, even after you fold flat the rear seats, there is a significant bit of step up, and you don't get a completely flat loading bay. However, you can still load very large items including your furniture along with a lot more things. So that was all about the boot. Now let's close it and conclude the review of this base level Comfort Line. So that was a detailed review of the brand new Volkswagen Taigun's entry level Comfort Line TSI variant. Just like the Skoda Kushaq's base level active variant, this also provides almost all the essential features you need on a base level variant of a premium SUV. While it may miss out on a lot of features you see on the Highline and the Topline variants, it definitely does not look basic on the outside, while also being impressively spacious and comfortable on the inside. It also provides all the essential safety features including ESP traction control and is also expected to perform well in the crash tests. So for the price, this base level comfort line Volkswagen Taigun seems to be good value for money. If you are willing to compromise on fancy features and want a safe, sensible and comfortable premium SUV. Only thing is you have to opt for front fog lamps and a reverse parking camera separately. So meanwhile, this is Viprajesh signing off. See you on another video. Thank you for watching.